Good morning students, welcome to physics online class. In previous class we discussed some topics related to this electric current, and there we discussed what is meaning of electric current, and what are conductors, what are insulator, how can we test the given material is a conductor or insulator by using the simple tester. Today I'm going to discuss about do liquids conduct electricity. Means here liquids also can conduct the electricity. We can understand by simple testers like this. Okay, here generally we arrange one circuit with help of two electrical components. One is the bulb. Generally here we are using normal bulbs. For example, first if we use this bulbs, okay, so bulb we are using, one end of the bulb is connected to the another end of the battery, and another end of the bulb is connected to this here, and here that freely we are suspending these two wires. Okay, so battery is a source of electrons. So when in a circuit, now just imagine that the circuit, now closed circuit or open circuit, na? So this is a closed circuit. Why? Because completely your circuit is closed. There is no gap here. Okay. So tell me, now this bulb will glow or not? Yes, bulb will glow. Once bulb is glown, we can understand that this battery and this bulb is working properly. Now to understand liquid conductivity here, in one small cap or a cup or a plastic cup we need to take, in this solution, any solution like lemon solution or vinegar, like that any solution we need to take into the cap, and these two wires should insert into this liquid. Understand, do you? So complete again water. We need to make one closed circuit. How it becomes like closed? Here this solution we taken, what is our role here? We need to understand this solution is a conductor or insulator. We need to understand that, so that before we checked this bulb is working normally and battery also working, so that when we insert these two wires into this, the one thing you have to understand here, this wire distance should not be too long, should not be too short. Minimum 1 centimeter distance should keep here. Okay, so that when we insert in this liquid, these two wires, what happened, Anna? When, if it is a conductor, we can observe that bulb will glow. Okay. If it is an insulator, bulb does not glow. Yes or no? So once we taken whatever the liquid we taken, if that liquid is a conductor, means we can observe this bulb will glow. If it is an insulator, bulb does not glow. Like that we can test the given solution is a, or a liquid is a conductor or insulator. Lemon and vinegar or that conductor, so we can observe that bulb will glow. Okay, so this is that generally we can test the liquids in this manner, but in some situations this bulb does not glow, because maybe the reason is whatever the liquid we are taking in this cap, this amount of liquid is not sufficient to get the electrons for this bulb. Why? Because for the working of this bulb, first the heating effect should be, filament need to heat up. Okay, filament need to heat up, after that it reduce that light energy, so that this amount of liquid is not sufficient to glow the bulb. Instead of that, to overcome this, here we can use, instead of this bulb, what type of bulbs we can use? LED. We can use LED bulbs. So for LED bulbs, two terminals will be, one long terminal and one short terminal. long terminal always should connect to a positive side and short connect to a negative side. So this LED also helpful to know the given liquid is a conductor or a insulator. But here in sometimes what happen, this because of this liquid, small amount of liquid, what happen, this LED will give very dim light. We can't observe this light. Compulsory we need to do this setup completely in a dark room. That time only we can see this LED is glowing or not. So this some these type of setups are helpful to know whether the conductor or the liquid is a conductor or insulator. But sometimes the bulb may not work properly. Because of that, we need to take some better testers to know whether the liquid is a conductor or insulator. In this, what we are using, instead of the bulb, we are using here magnetic compass. Okay, so compass is helpful to know the directions. Okay, so here compass, so the arrangement we are using here, battery, from the battery, one end of the battery is we are going to connect into the liquid. We taken the liquid in a small cup or a cap like structure we need to take, and we need to take some solution in this. And another end of the battery is connecting to the compass. Okay, so this compass should connect with this. Okay, so we can observe, what we can observe here in the presence of electricity. Okay, electric effect of means we can observe here presence of this from the battery to electrons will flow through this conducting wire. So when this solution, whatever the solution we taken in this, if it is a conductor, means we can observe some deflection in the needle of the magnetic compass. Here magnetic compass is there. When if electricity is passing through this, what will happen? This magnetic compass, this magnetic needle is there in this. This needle will show some deflection. Means this needle will turn either east direction or west direction. Like that, some deflection we can observe in the presence of conductors. If their insulators are there, means this needle will not change its direction. Okay, so it will not do any deflections. We can understand that the whatever the liquid is there in the cup is a insulator. Like that, we can test the given solution or a liquid is a conductor or insulator by using this type of tester. This type of tester will give to us very clear and correct idea about the conductors and the insulators. Okay, understand do you? So these are the certain methods to know that by using simple testers, these are we can understand, we can know about that what is the conductors, what are the insulators. Okay, so many liquids are there, like for example we can take lemon juice, we can take vinegar, we can take tap water, okay, salt water, okay, then we can take that pond water, kerosene, oil. These are the different liquids we have. You can take that some acid solutions like diluted HCl, okay, like some bases, base solutions we can take. All these are the different types of solutions we can take, and we can test these all solutions can conduct the electricity or not by using the simple testing methods. Okay, so if you take the water is a conductor only, but salt water is the best conductor. But when, why? Because here distilled water, when you take the distilled water, there is absence of minerals in the distilled water. Salt is absent in the distilled water. When there is no minerals and the salt components in the water, it does not conduct the electricity. pond water, salt, sea water, these all are having that some minerals in them. So that minerals are helpful to the water to conduct the electricity. It means electrons will flow through that. So it behaves like a conductors, liquid conductors. We call as liquid conductors. Okay. Okay, so when electricity is passing through this liquid conductors, some chemical effects are happening in them. That we are going to learn in the chemical effects of electric current. Okay, so some chemical effects are happening when electricity is passing through the liquid conductors. Okay, so this is what are conductor. How can we test the conductors? By using this type of tester. And how can we test? By using the compass. You need to learn this better tester is that we are using to know the whether the given liquid is a conductor or a insulator. Okay, so in the next class I will discuss with you about the chemical effects of electric current. Means what are the changes are happening when electricity is passing through a liquid. Okay, so different changes we are observing when electricity is passing through a liquid. This all we will study in the next class. Thank you students. Have a nice day.